I know I've been gone for a while, quite a few months, but my Stupid With Love animatic just got 1 million views, which is my first video to ever get 1 million views, and that's honestly really crazy to me. So since I always get questions on how I make my animatics, or people asking for tips on how I make my animatics, I've decided I'm gonna show you guys how I made my Stupid With Love animatic. Disclaimer, I am not a professional, and everyone has different and better ways to make animatics. Now, before this video begins, I actually have a super fun and quick announcement. You guys know that I love musicals. Well, I mean, you probably know that I love Mean Girls. There's no surprise there. But I do also really love other musicals, and musicals that I can't really do animatics for because I have no time to do them. So it's my honor to tell you guys that Amino, yes, the infamous and lovely Amino, actually has this new feature for stories, where it's kind of like other places that feature the story format, but people can put more time and effort into them and make them super fun. Interestingly enough, Amino reached out to me for me to make some stories of my own, which will probably range from behind the scenes videos to videos in a format that I normally don't work with. For example, I'm planning to make my first story a very small comparison of Regina George and Julius Caesar, because I love the video essay analysis format, but not enough to make a 10 to 20 minute video with it, so oops. I'm very excited to start making some more smaller videos on Amino, because I can get a very busy schedule, and I miss making videos. So, to check out my new Amino stories, you can search up my global profile, Oh It's Cosmo, which I'm sure won't be too hard to forget. And make sure you follow me, because I'll be uploading. Okay, anywho, there are 3 main stages when I make animatics. The first one is brainstorming, the second one is planning, and the third one is doing. No other word to explain it, just doing. So, let's start with brainstorming. Essentially, if I'm listening to a musical that I really like, Mean Girls! And I know I want to make an animatic, but I don't know what song I want to make an animatic for, I consider the following things. If I think the song is a bop, the length, if I already have automatic ideas for how I want to visualize it, or, /and, the amount of motivation I have to make it. These things usually drive my will to make an animatic. For example, for my Stupid With Love animatic, as soon as I heard the song, I loved it like so much. The length wasn't really a problem, it'd only really be an issue if it was crazy long. That's why I probably won't make a Revenge Party animatic ever. I really like the concept of the song, with the math and the love aspects, and I already had basic ideas for how I wanted to draw certain scenes. As for the motivation, I will say that I was still in my brainstorming phase when I first heard the song, and I only decided to make it into an animatic for Valentine's Day this year, so clearly I was having issues with motivation last year and clearly this year. With that being said, let's move on to step 2, planning. Planning is probably my favorite stage because it's the stage that just gets your hopes up and gets your gears running and convinces you that you're actually making the animatic when you're just planning it. When it comes to animation, everyone thinks of storyboarding as the main way to plan something. And while I sometimes do that, my main way of planning things is notes. I'm such a nerd. Okay, listen. For each lyric, each instrumental bit of a song, I write out what I envision for the animatic. Because I like to do things as I go, but not crazily as I go. I'm a left brain kind of person, I don't know what to say. These notes can get as descriptive from headshot frame of a person looking sad, you know, extreme long shot of the person in the center of the frame, bird's eye view of a person looking at a tree, I don't know. Or it can just be like, ha, look at them, they're standing over there, they're smiling, whatever. So these notes basically help me analyze the lyrics in a way, and they help me see what's coming up in the song so I can plan specific drawings for each line. While I plan, I listen to the song on repeat and analyze every little instrumental part, the way the singers sing, and if there's live performances, I'll usually watch them to see how the song is already interpreted. So, for example, on stage in New York, the part leading up to the second chorus where Katie is talking about Aaron's shiny eyes, she literally, like, reaches out and tries to touch him, but then he leans back in his chair. And I like that, so I used it in my animatic. Of course, I still had a lot of creative liberty that I utilized, but it's okay to take inspiration from here and there. If I'm struggling to figure out what I want to do for a certain line, then I'll try sketching different ideas on a separate piece of paper, usually from different angles with the character doing different things, just to have an idea of what would work best for the scene. Another part of the planning process is figuring out how I want to draw the characters, but I kinda sorta didn't do that for this animatic because I already drew them in my other Stupid With Love animatic, and I didn't plan out how I wanted to draw them before that one, so oops. Now, the big kahuna doing. This section of the video is gonna be hefty because I'm gonna explain everything to you. The first step, the preliminary step, is to prepare the file. So I open the audio file, which I download using this website, I'll leave a link, and I mark each major section of dialogue to help me figure out what to draw in one go. This is super, super helpful to keep track of everything. And you mark hitting the M key. Markers are lifesavers, and whatever editing tool you use, make sure you find out if they have markers. I add one large white frame as a main background in case I end up making my frames transparent PNGs to make things easier. I'll explain that later. Now time for the art. I open Clip Studio Paint and set the canvas size to 1920 pixels by 1080 pixels. For my Stupid With Love animatic, I didn't really do any basic sketching because I was trying to do a sketcher style, so I just went for it and hope for the best. Near the end, I did do some basic sketching to figure out how I wanted the poses to look because it got a little complex. I did separate layers for the face if I wanted to do multiple facial expressions or mouth shapes, which I usually do. So then I can easily duplicate the face layer, erase some features, and then redraw them. Here's something important to note. To get certain effects, like the background moving at a different speed than the foreground, or this pink vignette that I did, I saved certain frames as PNGs, and filled in the subject in the foreground with a white background so they would appear opaque when something moved behind them. This is super helpful and can give you a really nice effect. Now, we're gonna talk a bit about how to sort of draw. If you know absolutely anything about making short comics, about the elements and principles of art, or have watched any animated film, you will find that animatics are far more simple than anticipated. The animating part of it is a breeze. I will try my best to sum up how that kind of goes. So in animation, you have keyframes, your main poses, and where you want one pose to end up. In animation, you do those keyframes, and then you fill them in to get a smooth movement. But animatics are storyboards. You don't have to completely animate, so you just need the keyframes. And when it comes to animating how people talk, research is really important. There are lots of helpful tutorials that will show you the different shapes mouths make for different letters. But even without those tutorials, it's easy to discover that an oo sound makes an O shape for your mouth. When I'm done with all that art business, I save all my frames as PNGs or JPEGs, it doesn't matter too much, and I put it into a folder. Within a folder. I have a main folder for all my frames, which I number chronologically, then I put all the files in the second folder, and it makes everything nice and tidy. Usually, I'll open all the frames for one scene at a time and edit everything as I go along. It gives me a good sense of progress, and I don't have to do it all at once at the end. And if I give up, then I have something done at least, you know. If you want to move your frames to zoom in or do wacky stuff, Event Pan slash Crop is your best friend. You just put markers, resize that sucker, and boom, you're good. If you want a general movement across multiple panels, then Track Motion is your go-to. It does the same stuff, but make sure you pay attention to the preview. It can get a little wonky. Now, here's a predicament. What if you have stuff overlapping that you want to move in different directions? Just open a new video track! This way you can have text on top of frames, backgrounds, overlapping colors. This is a feature that people who make animatics or animated videos need to take advantage of, especially when they're first starting out. Additionally, you can add a Gaussian blur to give that out of focus effect. Finally, I might add some color correcting magic paired with some intro and outro magic. Then in Sony Vegas Pro, you want to make sure you're using the best rendering settings possible. So I'll include a video for that because I'm not entirely qualified to talk about rendering settings. And the last step is to make a thumbnail if I'm in the mood and upload to the tubes. I suppose that's all. If you have any, and I mean any, burning questions, feel free to either comment them or message me on Tumblr or Instagram. Thanks for watch!